Welcome to another edition of ProTech. Today we're going to be discussing a misdiagnosis problem with some power steering pumps. Have you ever gone through the process of installing a power steering pump with a remote or bolt-on reservoir, only to find that the pump is still noisy or isn't providing enough assist? Before making the assumption the replacement pump is bad, consider checking the bolt-on reservoir. This is found on a lot of late model, import, and domestic applications. There's a filter inside the reservoir designed to prevent debris from contaminating the steering system. The only drawback to this filter is that it doesn't have bypass capability, so once it becomes clogged with debris, it causes problems. To illustrate this issue, I have an example of a clean reservoir filter and two reservoirs that came off of separate vehicles. As you can see, the screen on the clean filter is free of debris and will allow power steering fluid to flow freely. This reservoir screen actually has a hole punched through it. Whoever did this realized the screen was clogged, but definitely took the wrong approach to fix the problem. Don't be guilty of this. Punching out the screen may get you past your immediate issue, but all the debris that was trapped on the screen is now floating around the system and will cause damage to the internal parts or get jammed in one of the valves. This one is very dirty and needs to be cleaned. All of this grit and debris is what clogs the filter. Products like brake cleaner or carb cleaner work well, but will cause seals and O-rings to swell and eventually leak if left in the system. So make sure to allow time for evaporation and use some shop air to blow out any remnants. The last step is to rinse out the reservoir screen with some fresh power steering fluid, just as an extra safety measure. So now that you've cleaned your reservoir, there's one last thing to do before bolting it onto the pump. The replacement power steering pump box contains a bag of new O-rings. Grab one of these O-rings and replace the reservoir O-ring. Starting with new O-rings will prevent leaks from occurring. Thanks for your time, and I hope this sheds some light on this potential problem with import and domestic late model applications.